Right, what's happening, guys? So, we have the Board of Love is back. I'm hoping I'm on camera, but it doesn't really matter if you can't see my mug. As long as you can see the right there on you, the shit that I'm chatting to, we're all good. Okay, so, your girl Lou asked a very good question. What's the difference between bodyweight training and weight training? Well, to be honest, for the general population, is the convenience factor. I didn't know how to spell convenience, so I just made up letters for it. So the convenience factor for the gen pop is basically what's gonna be more applicable to your training with your time constraints. So have you got 30 minutes to travel to the gym, do your hours training, travel 30 minutes back? If so, fucking great, crack on with that. If you lack the time, then bodyweight training might be more ideal for you in the sense that you could just do it at home, in the fucking field somewhere, on the beach, wherever you want, just using less time. So you're taking up the time for traveling, etc. So if you have little people running around, you have dogs that you need to take care of, like mine is a full-time job taking care of him, you need to save that time, then bodyweight training would be better for you. So convenience factor is gonna be the main ingredient, I guess, to what's gonna be best for you to do. Okay, so moving on. Building muscle. Guys, any programming, training program is gonna come down to building muscle. It is the be all and end all. If it's fat loss, you need to build muscle. If you're trying to get bigger, you need to build muscle. So, overloading the muscles is how we build muscle, okay? So by overloading the muscles, I mean we need to break down the muscle fibers, allow them to rebuild and then increase in size or mass. So for that, there's three areas that we can do that by. That's resistance, so that's adding weights or dumbbells. So when you're doing a pressing motion or a pulling motion, using a dumbbell or a barbell, for instance. If you're doing body weight to add resistance, you can use things like weighted vests or fucking resistance bands. Okay, volume. So that's the amount of reps we need to do. So increasing the volume of the repetitions that we do also helps build muscle. You can do that with body weight, just obviously, instead of 15 press ups, you do 20, same with weight. So, okay, same principle going on there. And tempo, again, guys, the other way that we build muscle, and same again, it's the same principle for body weight and weight. So, you bring this weight down slow, like we've talked about previously, slow on the way down, fast push. Or if you're doing a pull, fast pull down, steady on the way up. Remember, it's the eccentric phase that builds muscle. So that's where we use the slow tempo. Again, you could do that with your barbells, your dumbbells. You can use it doing it with a weighted vest. If you're doing a press up, come down slow, push up fast. If you're doing a bodyweight squat with a vest on, same, slow down, fast up. Okay, that's all ways we can increase tempo to build muscle. I feel like I'm talking really fast. I just had a pre-workout, so that's probably what that is. Okay, so that's the areas. And then moving on, it's the frequency. So how frequent can we train? It's keeping that consistency level, whether it is body weight or weight, that is gonna determine how successful you are with your results. Okay, and then what we got? Your girl M asked a good question. So she was during lockdown using her TRX to impress us, weighs 80 kilos. Is that the same? Does that transfer across to a bench press at 80 kilos? And the answer is no. Basically, just because you're doing two types of different sort of training there. So on a TRX, you're indirectly training the chest. So by that, what I mean is, so if you're doing your press up and an incline, the weight is distributed between the body. So instead of being directly focused on the chest, the weight is distributed, well, from head to toe, really. So that takes away that thought of your press at 80 kilos. Does that make sense? So, whereas if you're doing a bench press, you're directly working the chest. So the press is, all the weight is directly on that chest, the 80 kilo then becomes a lot harder. I hope that makes sense. So again, when you're using TRX and things like that, you're indirectly working muscle groups. So it's more of a compound sort of movement, using multi-joints, multi-muscles, okay, for a certain exercise. Whereas if you're doing it with weights, it's more of a direct hit on that muscle group that's working. I hope that all makes sense. watching the video. Any questions, just put in the comments and I'll do my best to answer for you. Lush, have a good day.